Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about stack implementation in JavaScript. You can implement a stack either just by creating a class or just by creating a function. So we will use all different approach. We will talk about what all different methods we can create inside a class, what all functionalities which stack is providing, like helper methods, push, pop, peep, count, all these methods are there. I mean, these peak is somewhat called as a peep or something. So push is something like which you are adding something on the stack. Pop means you are removing the topmost element from the stack. Okay, peak is just going to check, okay, the element is there or not. Empty will just check if stack is empty or not. Size will give you just a size of the stack. Okay, so we have already talked about the stack data structure, how it is different from any other data structure. You can consider it's like a vertical stack of dishes, vertical stack of plates. You can see these are vertical stack of plates, right? Now if you wanted to remove any of the plate, what you will do, you will remove this plate first, then this plate, and then this plate. Whenever you are adding a plate in the stack, then you will keep adding from top. You will add this plate, then add this plate, and you will add another plate on top of it. This is how it works, right? This is a stack data structure which works on the principle of last in, first out. It means whatever is getting inserted last will be removed first. Okay, so we have decided that we are going to have a push operation to add a new element in the stack, and pop is to remove the elements from the stack. And stack is just a data structure, a pattern of arranging the elements. Now this data structure pattern can be implemented either by a simple object or a simple array using linked list or using queue. Now we are talking about JavaScript implementation first. So what we will do is we will create a class, we will have a either array or object inside it, and then we will do a keep adding the new elements inside it using push, and we'll remove the elements, the topmost elements from it using pop. So if we talk about simple array, const x, I'm just writing a pseudo code how we can thought about it. So when you do a push, right, so what we can do is we can just insert a new element. So there is already a method in JavaScript x.push 7, right? So it will get added in the last of the array, right? Now whenever you want it to pop, you can just remove this particular element. It will be a pop. So if you do a push two times, like 9 and 0, and now you want it to pop, so pop will just remove the topmost element. Okay, so in this way array can be constructed to satisfy the condition of stack also. So push will keep adding here, like this is an array, and here I keep doing a push, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, and whenever you do the pop, these elements will keep removing. Okay, now you will see the empty stack. Okay, so if you write a pseudocode, what it will be, we'll create a stack class, constructor function, we'll create a set count to 0, or consider that we are going to do it with the functions, create a storage object, right? Then we will write a push method, and we will write a pop method. So push method, it will just insert a new element inside the object. Key will be the count. So if you are adding the second element, the key inside the object will be the count, and count will keep increasing whenever you are adding. Similarly, the pop method, you will just remove the last count and decrease the count, and whenever nothing is left inside a object, then you just return the undefined or empty. Okay, so these are the different methods are involved. Now if you just try to write this particular code and see how it is going to behave, right? So if you try to implement this stack with just a simple class and all, so we can do that. Let's write our simple code for it. So what we can do is we can just create a const stack. Okay, and we are going to write functions. This can be also done with the help of classes. So what we are doing is First, we will set the count, which is 0, and we can also do this dot storage, which is empty object. Okay, this is how I have initialized my stack. Now in JavaScript you can create a prototype on to the function, right? So what I will do is stack dot prototype, and here I will add a method push, and I will write the definition of this push. Push means you wanted to insert a value, right? So here I will write a push. Similarly, we can write another methods, which is like pop method we can write, and size, basic functions we are taking care for now. Okay, so what push method will do? This is push, this is pop. So push method will just insert a new element to the array, right? So here we have a this dot storage. Okay, here this dot storage, and we will see what is the current count, this dot count, and we will add the value. Okay, and this dot count plus plus, we'll just increase the count, right? This is how we have inserted a element inside a object, right? Now count will increase, the next key will become the count plus plus, which is 1, and the new value whatever you wanted to insert. Pop is nothing but it will just check if your count is this dot count. If this dot count equal to zero, then what you need to do, you need to return undefined. Otherwise what you will be doing, you will just decrease the count, this dot count minus minus, because you have the element. First you will just var result, and we have to get the element, right? So we can get it using this dot storage is an object, and we can just pass the count, this dot count, and we can just delete this particular object, this particular key from the object, this dot storage and this dot count. Okay, so and we can return this result, I mean the pop value which we just received. Okay, so it can be simple as constant. Okay, this is our pop method, this is our push method, and now size, it will just return this dot count, right? So simple implementation of stack using simple functions. Similarly, we can also write classes. Now if you see, what we have done is in this storage object we have this count property. Once you keep adding the new elements, count keeps increasing, and we are just storing this stack as a data structure inside a simple object like this. So the final structure, this is a storage object, right? Here it will have some values, something like this. So storage.count 0 will have your initial value like a you have inserted, right? On now on another index 1 you have inserted something like b. Now here if you do a pop, right, so what you will do, you are just decreasing the count, and then this dot count, right, you are removing the element a, right, and that deleting this particular property, and then whenever you are doing pop, you are just getting rid of that count and deleting this property and returning that. Okay, so you also deleting this property, so this particular index will go away whatever you are popping up. Okay, so this is using just an object. In the next video we can talk about the implementation using class also. In class we will just create a push, pop, p, size, count, all these functions.